From one fight on to the next, two outlaws ride with weapons flexed. One is quick, the other's tall. Together they'll kill them all. Bang, bang, they shot them down. Bang, bang, they hit the ground. Bang, bang, they torch the rest. Bang, bang, with lasers from their chest. Bang, bang, their kill counts rise. Bang, bang, their enemies die. Bang, bang, better hit the ground. Bang, bang, here's the rocket sound.
Frameshift drive charging. approach. Welcome, Commander.
Shields offline. Thermal signature restored. Shields online.
Thank you. tired in ages.
Yeah. Maybe you should try sleeping. I did one last night. Not me right now.
Really? I think the constant shift changes have destroyed my sleep schedule.
Yeah. Sometimes the only rest I get is after a few glasses of Lady and Brandy.
Sure. Can I help you, Commander?
Trading, selling, or both? Whatever you need to sell, I can handle it. Will that be all? Have a look. The only thing you won't find is a discount.
Got that time off I asked for. I think I might go exploring. You got any ideas where to start? Have you ever seen the California Nebula? If you haven't, you should.
You got it. Anything else?
Sure.
I'm always at your disposal, Commander.
Every time I head out, I never know what's waiting for me.
Just last week, I got caught up in a time
the Beluga liner. Network access is temporarily unavailable.
Thank you.
has been lifted. Best of luck, Commander.
Ready to engage.
been scanned by 50%.
Message.
Surface scanned by 50%. Surface scan complete.
Engaged. Shields online.
Established, we are ready to receive docking requests. Permission granted. A landing pad has been assigned to you.
Engaged.
Thank you. To prevent any damage to the lab. It's not a perfect solution, but at least it hasn't eaten through the floor. Tomorrow, I'm gonna find out exactly what makes this thing tick.
I will now continue with the physical examination. Let the record show that Professor Collins is present to assist. The probe is organic in appearance, but seems to possess many inorganic properties. The outer casing is made of elements we have been unable to identify. Thus far, radiocarbon testing has proved inconclusive. Attempts to dissect the outer carapace with a conventional scalpel have also been unsuccessful. We simply don't have a blade that can pierce the shell. I am now proceeding with electrocauterization. The laser has made an incision. The probe appears to be reacting. simulation is pulsating. Professor Bouchard, I'm reading an increase in atmospheric pressure within the lab. Ion number 5.
I must say this is fascinating. Upon making my primary incision, the probe emitted an electromagnetic pulse that shut down the entire laboratory and most of the research facility. Luckily, auxiliary power kicked in and kept our life support online. If it hadn't, we might have found ourselves a little short of air. The tech team has restored power to the main systems, but most of my hardware has been destroyed. My examinations will have to be put on hold until the equipment can be replaced or repaired. Who knows how long that will take. There is one curious thing, though. Since it released the pulse, the probe has been emitting a constant signal. We have no idea what it's trying to communicate. But comms have assured me they have their best cryptographer on the job. The signal the probe was giving off has been answered. We're under attack and evacuation protocols have been initiated. What is assaulting us has systematically taken the supplement apart. We tried to hail it to show them we mean no harm, but there's no answer. I've been given the order to evacuate. I'm leaving a ton of research behind, but there's no time to upload it to the mainframe. I just hope we can get out of here before the whole thing. We've secured a specimen. One of our suppliers purchased the probe on the black market. It was expensive, but worth it. This thing is magnificent. It's sitting in the...
makeshift drive charging.
Scoop deployed.
Cargo scoop retracted.